Hello guys, my name is Udeaja Ben and welcome to the 28 days Vectorink logo design war. And you know, this is a 28 days logo challenge, and you know, it's gonna run for 28 days. I'm gonna be creating logos with using just the Vectorink application. Now the purpose is for mastering, okay, the Vectorink application specifically for logo design, because you know, most clients always request for, you know, Skillshare vector graphics, that is SVG. And you know, if you don't have the SVG, you know, it looks awkward, because of course you should provide, you know, enough files for your client, so you don't get to lose, you know, that much clients. So you know, and again, you know, this is very, very important if you are working on freelance sites, because most of your clients are going to be requesting for the SVG file for the logo. And if there's a way that you manipulate just to get an SVG, now there is going to be a problem, because now that client might not come back to you because he felt like, okay, maybe you cheated on him or her, because actually you actually converted the, you know, JPG file or PNG file to the SVG. Okay, you know, there are sites that you can actually use that, you know, used to do that. For example, if you design a logo using pixellab, you know, there are sites that you can actually visit to actually change it from PNG or SVG to, sorry, from PNG or JPG to SVG, that is Skillshare vector graphics. But I recommend you actually use the Vectorink application for your logo designs. Okay, then if you, whenever you want to design banners and, you know, every other stuff, you can use pixellab for that. Now nevertheless, you know, you can still use the Vectorink application for you know, for banners also. If you want to design banners, it's still possible using the Vectorink application. But mainly we're going to be, you know, we are like our main concentration is going to be on the logo design. And you know, purposely this particular challenge is for mastering. So this is the day one, okay, of the 28 days Vectorink logo design war. So we're gonna be starting out, and I think, you know, after, you know, much research, and I think instead of explaining the app, you know, I think using, you know, logo designs as example actually make you master the application without me even explaining the app to you. So let's get right into the application. So in order to create a new project, just click on this add button. So I'm gonna create let me import the image, okay, of the logo that I want to use. So that is the sketched image of the logo that I want to vectorize. So I'm gonna click on this, and this is this particular version is actually the latest version. So okay, I got this from the Play Store. So you can actually get it from Play Store. You can just pay for the, you know, for the subscription. It's actually, I think it's 2000 something there. So it's actually cheap. So you can just pay for the subscription. But if you need the version 3.0, I still have the version 3.0, and it's gonna be in the link in the description. So now the version 3.0 is actually free. Now the problem here is that the version 3.0 actually have something that this latest version doesn't have, and this latest version also has something that the version 3 doesn't have. So you know, both, I actually use both of them, you know, depending on which design that I want to use. For example, if I must design a logo using the golden ratio, then of course I have to use the version 3, because you know, it allows me to manipulate and, you know, come up with, you know, golden rectangles, sorry, golden squares and all of that. So let's get right into it. So I'm going to click on these three dots and import an image. So here's the image I want to import. Right, we have it right here. So I want to scale down, then click on it, scale down a bit. And be careful not to stretch it. So I want to position this at the middle. So I want to click on this arrow and come to this and click on this little of this. So once it's, you know, once it's set, so I want to click on this and go back. All right, so once you have that in the middle, so the next thing is to actually click on this icon and lock this particular layer and create a new layer at the top. So once you're done with that, just click on this. And yeah, so let's start, you know, creating the vectorization. So I'll click on this icon And normally I should have just used lines alone, but one thing is that I might not be able to take, you know, keep track of the width, as if I don't want to use the grid line. So I don't want to use the grid line. Most times I don't actually use the grid lines. I just used, you know, just this one alone, because I could just establish just a particular, you know, rectangle, then use it throughout. So I'm gonna come down, you know, pinch in and draw. Then click here to just edit it. You know, make it big so you don't have to, you know, you just have to be doing this to actually be copying in it, and, you know, pasting. So once you're done with this, the next thing is to actually, you know, take this out. Don't worry about it, just take it out and duplicate it. Now we want to get this this side like this, because if you're not careful you might actually miss the angle. So the next thing is actually, you know, let's give it an angle, let's say 45. Let's see if that will actually be okay. So let's move this over here. Let's see, 45. I think we should try 50. First, let's go back to zero. Let's try 50. Yeah, 50 should be okay. So 50 is okay. So just position it right here. And the next thing is to actually duplicate this. Duplicate. Once you duplicate it, just come back to this place and click on zero. Okay, it's just on zero right now. So let's click on, let's go back to 50 and see. No, I think we should get rid of this and go back to this one. You know that was why we actually dropped that size, so we can actually go back to it and, you know, and always copy it. So copy, drag, and this time it's gonna be, instead of 50, it's gonna be negative 50. So minus 50. So once you test, just, you know, just make sure it's exactly, yeah. So once this is perfect, the next thing is to actually copy it again. Okay, copy this one, move it down a bit right here. Once you're done with that, then this one also copy and move down. All right, so this is okay. So once you're done with that, just, you know, perfect. Then the next thing is to actually copy this also and bring it over here. Duplicate also. Bring it over here. Duplicate. Duplicate. Right there. So the next thing is to actually go back, and of course we need a line, okay, that should run from here to here. So just need just a line. We need to move the line up, so it's actually a bit low, so let's move it up. It should be perfect. So what you're done with that is just scale out and make sure this is activated and, you know, highlight everything. then click on this icon right here and click on this. So let's zoom in and start vectorizing. Okay, at this point, you know, I had problem connecting these 2 points, so I'm still gonna go back and re-edit this. So let's go back. So once you are back, just I think that light is gone, that line is gone, so let's recreate it. I think if it's up a bit, I think it should work. And the thing is that let's go back, and I think this is what is giving me that problem. This, let's see if we can actually reduce the size of this. I think we're going to tamper with the no, I think we should go back. Best thing is to actually make sure this line is actually above that point there. Okay, let's go back. All right, so I'll repeat the same thing. Then we start again. You're almost done. Yeah, you're done. And of course, our logo is ready. Our logo is actually ready. So, so once you're done, just, you know, just scale out and click on this icon. And yeah. So let's go back to this layer and make this invisible so we'll be able to see what is under. And so here is our logo. Yeah, and of course we don't need this again, so let's just delete this and, you know, highlight everything here and scale up. Now you don't want to stretch it like this or scale it up just like this. So just, you know, for you, you know, for you to scale it up so you don't deform it, just click on here first. So once it's set, then you can just scale up. Our logo is actually ready, so we need to post center align this, then fill it up with a color. megabytes, so how long is available. So I'm going to save this as SVG or export as SVG. I'm going to export as SVG. What I normally do is to actually export it to my Telegram, and it's easier for me to save it to my downloads, okay, to a particular file that I want to save it to. So I'm just going to send it to my Telegram. Alright, so once it's right, you just click on these three dots and then save to download. So this file is going to be on your download as SVG. Now, how do you convert it back to JPG or PNG? Of course, you have to use your you can download JPG and PNG to SVG applications on Play. So just type, just search for JPG PNG to SVG on Play Store. Of course, we see many apps that can do that. But you can still use Photo P to do that. Just export it or import it into Photo P and remove the background and export as JPG or PNG. Alright, and I will see you in the next video. And don't forget to leave a like and comment if you have any question on this particular video. If you have any question, just comment. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any update from this channel. And I will see you in the next video.